In this illustration, we'll analyze the deformation and breaking of a bone. We are given that if a compressive force of 3 into 10 to the power 4 Newton is exerted on the end of 20 centimeter long bone of cross-sectional area 3.6 centimeter square, then we are required to find if the bone will break or the deformation in the bone. And we are given that the compressive strength of bone is this value, and Young modulus of bone is also given to us. So here in solution, we can first calculate the stress developed in bone is a value of a stress we can write as sigma, which is equal to the applied force upon cross-sectional area. And here the force is 3 into 10 to the power 4 divided by the area is 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 4. And this is numerically giving us 8.33 into 10 to the power 7 Newton per meter square. This is the stress developed in the bone. And here we can write, if the stress is less than the compressive strength of bone, then it will not break. And we are given that the compressive strength of bone is given by this value. So here we can write as sigma is less than compressive strength of bone. This implies it will not break. This is one result of the problem. And we are also required to find the deformation in bone. We can write, if deformation in bone is delta L, then here we use the Young modulus of bone is stress by strain. So here stress we already calculated as sigma divided by strain, we can write as delta L by L. This implies here the value of delta L we are getting is sigma L upon Young modulus. So stress we already calculated as 8.33 into 10 to the power 7 multiplied by length of the bone is 20 centimeter, which is 0.2, divided by the Young modulus is 1.5 into 10 to the power 10. If numerically we solve it, this gives us 1.11 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter, which is 1.11 millimeter. That is the result of this problem.